kindness of a savior, the nation. Savior, he can move a mountain. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation, he rose and conquered.
Conquer the grave. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, worship Your holy name. Your You're slow to anger. Your name is great, and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness, I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Bless You, Lord. His holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy name. Yes, I will worship Your holy name. Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul.
Father, Spirit, Son. For this 9 o'clock service, just turn to your neighbor and wave at your neighbor. We welcome all of you, the physical congregation, even those who are following online. We welcome you and we pray that God will minister to you today. The night has passed. I kindly request that we stand. The night has passed and the day lies before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind as we rejoice in the gift of a new day. The light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you now and forever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we have come together as the family of God in our Father's presence to offer him thanks and praise. Praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive his holy word, to bring before him the needs of the world, to ask his forgiveness of our sins, and to seek his grace, that through his Son, Jesus Christ, we may give our souls to his service. And if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins to Almighty God, he is faithful and just. He will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all and righteousness. You may be seated. Just take a minute and reflect on your personal life. Think about the week, how the week has been, and think about this day that God has given you. Think about his love for you. Think about all that he has done for you. Our God is a merciful God. He is always ready to forgive us and welcome us back home. O Lord, hear our prayers. May our cries come unto you. I request that we open our eyes as we all join in that confessional prayer and we pray together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our fellow men in thought, word, and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May the Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The collect of the day. Today is the 20th Sunday after Trinity, and I request that we say the collect together. Almighty God and merciful we beseech from all things that may hurt us, that we may be ready both in body and soul, may cheerfully accomplish those things that you have done, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips. May we arise and give glory to God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and forever and ever. Amen. Once again, you're very welcome. You are welcome to this 9 o'clock service. Just welcome someone next to you. Say you're welcome in the presence of God. And God has been so good to us. Let's appreciate God for this day that he has given to us. And we are blessed to have the team itself leading us. Let's welcome them as we join them to worship the Lord. May the Lord richly bless you as we continue.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. Is this the day the Lord has made? Is this the day the Lord has made? Let's rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. The Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. Help me say, this is the day. We rejoice. put those hands together. Come on. Singing, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Lord has made. I will rejoice.
I will rejoice and be glad in
it. And be glad. Holding on to you, 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 holding on to Jesus, holding on to Jesus, holding on to Jesus. Of all things, and we just want to give you the glory for every blessing, for your goodness towards us, your mercy that speaks for us every day, that is new every morning. Just open your heart to his spirit, to his word, as we come into his courts. Reflect on the mercies of God and his goodness. Think about his goodness with a flame of affection. Just exalt him in your hearts of hearts. Oh, we give you glory, Lord.
You are wonderful. You
You're so good, God. You're so good. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless your holy name. We thank you, Lord, for yet another opportunity you've given us to be in your presence. We thank you, Abba, Father, for see how you provided, how you've taken care of us, Lord. We thank you for our families, Lord. We thank you, Lord, you've taken care of us, Lord. We thank you for our church, Lord. Thank you for His Grace, the Archbishop. Thank you for the House of Bishops. We thank you for all the clergies, Lord. Thank you for the ladies, Lord. We thank you, Lord, because you've called us, Lord, to serve you. Father, we thank you for our nation, Lord. We thank you for our president, Lord, and all leaders, Lord. We thank you, Lord, because you've been our God, Lord. You've guided us, Lord. You've protected this nation, Lord. Lord, we are so grateful, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. And we, Lord, we bring unto you the men and women, Lord, you've gathered this morning. The scripture tells us that you don't gather many and you don't do anything, Lord. Lord, we ask for special blessings, Lord. Bless us, Lord. Bless our families, Lord. Lord, I pray that you'll meet all our needs according to your riches in glory, Lord. We thank you, Lord, because you are our God. Even when we go through the valleys of death, Lord, you've never departed from us. We thank you, Lord. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Friends, let's together join the words of the Apostles' Creed as we affirm our faith. On page 7. Together, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his Son. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting.
Amen. Amen. Let's together join in the words of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God. Let's now welcome the word, minister of the word.
Church, good morning, church. Our reading of today has been picked from the book of Daniel, chapter 6. The reading starts from verse 1. Daniel, chapter 6, the reading starts from verse 1. And verse 1 reads, "It pleased Darius to set over the kingdom 120 satraps to be throughout the whole kingdom, and over them 3 high officials, of whom Daniel was one, to whom these satraps should give account, so that the king might suffer no loss. Then this Daniel became distinguished above all the other high officials and satraps, because an excellent spirit was in him. And the king planned to set him over the whole kingdom. Then the high officials and the satraps sought to find a ground for complaint against Daniel with regard to the kingdom, but they could find no ground for complaint or any fault, because he was faithful and no error or fault was in him. Then this man said, 'We should not find any ground for complaint against this Daniel unless we find it in connection with the law of his God.'" Brethren, this is the word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord again. Is somebody happy? Amen. Wave your hand if you're happy. Wave to the Lord. Hallelujah. You are welcome to church this morning, and we welcome those who have joined us online. We are aware of many St. Franciscans in the diaspora, and many, of course, here in Uganda, who are not able to join us physically. But wherever you are, you are welcome, and may God richly bless you. We welcome our television audience, the Church of Uganda Family TV, now on Star Times 282, channel 282, Star Times. The territory is enlarging. You can also access Family TV on Go TV, channel 829. And we also welcome our television audience of Right Television, and many who are following online on our main social media platforms: YouTube, is Fuel My Faith, Twitter, and Facebook. There's a way in which people still access Facebook. I don't know how they do it, but they do. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord again. So you're welcome. It's good to see people in church, because there's something about people gathering. It's something to do with something beautiful about people coming together. Even when we are wearing our face masks, it doesn't matter. I may not see your smile, but at least you are here. And I want to appreciate the ministry of the clergy among us. A number of them are around, and you have seen them. But I also want to welcome the team, ASAF, that is ministering with us, Oops, they're also not here, but we've seen them. And so today we are in for a treat. Tell you a treat. Our preacher today, I'll not say many things. You can access all notices on our social media platforms. We are in a university community, and you know that, of course, you can give the love gifts if you see the white envelope, the church house love gift. And so follow the notices, bands of marriage, they're all available on our website and other platforms. We are privileged to have a servant of God minister to us, bring forth the word of God to us today. This is Mike Chibita. Some people call him Michael, but I heard his wife calling him Mike, so I will also call him Mike. I think Mike is cooler than Michael. That's how you call me Uncle O. Some people used to call me Uncle Onesimus. They say, no, Uncle O is cooler. So, Justice Mike is a Ugandan lawyer and judge who serves on the Supreme Court of Uganda. Do we have some lawyers here? By show of hands. A student of law is a lawyer in the making. So, wonderful. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. May you draw a lot of inspiration today from the preacher. And Justice Mike served for 6 years, I think, because it was from 2013 to 2019. He served as the Director of Public Prosecution in Uganda. And prior to that, he served as a Justice of the High Court of Uganda. So you can imagine now that is the preacher today. Are we not privileged? Just clap to the Lord. Just clap to the Lord. And he came graciously with his dear wife, Mrs. Monica Badia Chibita, who is here, and in her own right, she is a media professional, an academic administrator who serves currently as a professor and dean, Faculty of Journalism, Media and Communication at Uganda Christian University. How come the clapping was less than the former? Okay. They have also come with their daughter, Vanessa, but the dad will introduce them better. Earlier, there was Benezeri, their son, is towering. He's taller than the father. And we are so privileged that you could come to minister to us. Somebody was asking me yesterday, they said, how do you get somebody of that caliber to preach at St. Francis Chapel? And I said, well, he is born again. A man of unquestionable and impeccable integrity in the judiciary. And there are not many. There are not many of his kind. And so we could not have thought of any better speaker today to address the topic of sowing in the marketplace. And I pray that God will bless you greatly as you receive God's word. But before he comes, we will invite the drama team to prepare the way for him. God bless you.
Organize that case we are going to work on today.
Thank you.
Yes,
God.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
You are an official wife, but not from our family. Only that is our family land.
Your family land? When I also contributed?
You contributed that money that you contributed. I was the one providing for everything.
Let us go. And we shall sort it out.
Putting it out in which way you have, you don't even deserve to take any portion of my property.
Who told you? Who told you?
You came with nothing.
I am your official wife.
You have even given me a child. We went and wedded officially. But now, your child, we are here. Okay.
You're touching a wrong note.
Where's the child? At least if I give you 30%, then you have given me.
How hopeless you are!
Look at this. You're calling me hopeless. You're calling me hopeless.
Believe me.
Let me tell you, your case is for Friday. Why are you people coming on Mondays like this?